Hello viewers, comparing numbers from 100 to 200 in class 2 is what we are going to see in this video. Welcome to my channel PMCE. We are seeing one of the learning outcome under number concepts in class 2, which is comparing numbers. Let us go into the details of this video. These are the learning outcomes in class 2 under the number concepts. The first learning outcome is place value concepts. As in class 2, we will be dealing with 3-digit numbers. We will be looking at the place values 1s, 10s and 100s. The next learning activity is the number activities, like after numbers, before numbers and in between numbers, on the numbers from 100 to 200. The next learning outcome is comparing 2-digit numbers with 3-digit numbers and comparing 3-digit numbers among themselves. The other learning outcomes are odd and even numbers, ordinal numbers and story sums, which means problem sums. Dear viewers, if you are here for the first time, I have explained in detail about each of these learning outcomes in my class 2 learning outcome video. The link for the same is given below in the description box, also in the iCard section. I have dealt with place value concepts in separate videos and the number activities in the numbers 100 to 200 in separate video. The links for the same are also given below in the description box. In this video, we are going to see about comparing numbers. Under this, we will be seeing how to identify the smallest number, how to identify the greatest number, usage of symbols to compare the numbers, and arrange the numbers in increasing and decreasing order. So stay with me till the end of this video to learn all these. Before going into comparing 3-digit numbers, I'd like to give you a quick revision of what you learnt in your class 1. In class 1, we would have dealt with 2-digit numbers and we had a set of rules to compare the 2-digit numbers. Let us take a quick look at them. In 2-digit numbers, the number with smaller tens digit is smaller and the number with the greater tens digit is greater. Let us see an example. Here I have given two 2-digit numbers, 37 and 89. So as per the rules, look at the tens place first. We have 3 and 8. 3 is lesser than 8. So the number with smaller tens is smaller. So 37 is smaller than 89. Let us look at another example. We have 94 and 29. So, we'll have to look at the tens place where we have 9 and 2. 9 is greater than 2. So, 94 is greater than 29. The next rule is, in 2-digit numbers, if the tens digit is the same, compare the ones digit. The number with the smaller ones digit is smaller and the number with the greater ones digit is greater. Here, we had different numbers in the tens place. Suppose you have the same number in the tens place. The rule is to next look at the ones place. So here we have 61 and 69, which has the same tens place. And when you look at the ones place, it is 1 and 9. We know that 1 is lesser than 9. So 61 is smaller than 69. Let us do another example. We have 77 and 73. Here the tens place is same, so look at the ones place, we have 7 and 3. We know that 7 is greater than 3, so 77 is greater than 73. I just wanted to do a quick revision of this before we go into 3-digit numbers. Let us also look at the usage of symbols. We have learned this also in our class 1. This is a greater than symbol, and how to remember this is, here you have 2 points in this symbol, and you have 1 point on the right side. So you always read any digit or any content from left to right. So in this symbol, we have 2 points on the left and 1 point on the right. We know that 2 is always greater than 1. So this is the symbol for the greater than, 2 and 1. So 2 is greater than 1 and this is the symbol to remember for greater than. Next, this is the lesser than symbol. So here in the left side we have 1 point, on the right side we have 2 points. We know that 1 is lesser than 2. So this symbol is for lesser than. Another way to remember is it resembles the alphabet L. L is for lesser. Another symbol which is used for comparison is equal to. Let us go on to the next topic now. Now that we have seen the comparison of two-digit numbers, now we are going to see comparison of a two-digit number and three-digit number. The simple rule is a number with more digits is always greater. A three-digit number is always greater than a two-digit number, or a two-digit number is always greater than a single-digit number. So here we have 92 and 156, and we know that 92 is lesser than 156, or 156 is greater than 92. So what is the symbol you will use? 92 is lesser than 156. The symbol to be used is lesser than symbol. Next question is 138 and 89. This is a 3-digit number and this is a 2-digit number. So we know that 138 is greater than 89. And next we have 2 3-digit numbers, 170 and 170. Another symbol for comparison is equal to. So when you see the same number on the either side, you use the symbol equal to. Next, let us go into comparison of 3-digit numbers. The first step is to compare the number of digits. Suppose you compare and you see that both of them have 3 digits. The next step is to compare the hundredths digit. The number with smaller hundredths digit is smaller and the number with greater hundredths digit is greater. Let us see this with an example. We have 200 and 127. First step we saw both of them are 3-digit numbers. Next step is to see the hundredths digit. In the hundredths digit you have ones, tens, hundreds. You have 2 and here you have 1. So we know that 2 is greater than 1 and 200 is greater than 127. Suppose in the hundredths place you have the same number. Then what you will do? Go to the step 2 and see what we'll have to do for that. If the digits in the hundredths place are same, compare the tens digit. We'll have to look at the number in the tens digit. The number with smaller tens digit is smaller and the number with greater tens digit is greater. Let us see this with an example. So we have 2 3-digit numbers, 139 and 161. First look at the hundredths place. You have 1 in both the numbers. So as per the rule, next you have to look at the tens place. In tens place you have 3 and here 6. We know that 3 is lesser than 6. With that you can conclude that 139 is lesser than 161. Next point is, suppose you have 2 3-digit numbers where the hundredths place are same and also the tens place. If the digits in the tens place is also same, you'll have to go to step 3. What you will do is, if the digits in hundredths place and tens place are both same, next you'll have to jump to the ones digit. The number with the smaller ones digit is smaller and the number with greater ones digit is greater. The rule is always the same. The digit with smaller number is smaller and the digit with greater number is greater. But then if it is a 3-digit number, first you'll have to look at the hundredths place, then into the tens place and then at the ones place. Let us see this with an example. So you have 184 and 180. Here the hundredths place is both 1. Tens place, next you have to see both are 8. So what is the rule? Next you have to look at the ones place. In the ones place you have 4 and 0. We know that 4 is greater than 0. So 184 is greater than 180. Now that we have learnt all the rules for comparison of 3-digit numbers, 100 to 200, let us do some exercises. Compare the numbers and put the correct symbol. Here I have given you a 2-digit number 89 and 101, which is a 3-digit number. What is the answer? We know that a 2-digit number is lesser than a 3-digit number. So you put the lesser than symbol. Next question is, you have 2 3-digit numbers, 187 and 178. The rule is to first look at the hundreds place. Both are having a 1. So next you'll have to look at the tens place where 8 and 7 are there. We know that 8 is greater than 7. So you can conclude 187 is greater than 178. Next question is 190 and 193. So here in the hundreds place you have both 1. Next look at the tens place. You have 9 in both the digits as the tens place value. So next you'll have to jump to the ones place. Here you have a 0 and here you have a 3. We know that 0 is lesser than 3. With that you can conclude that 190 is lesser than 193. Hope you are clear with the rules and able to understand how we are going about with this exercise. Now we have 157 and 157. What is the answer for this? You have to put an equal to symbol over here because both the digits are same. And both the values are also same. Next you have 138 and 133. So we'll have to look at the ones place in this case because hundreds and tens place are same. 8 is greater than 3, so 138 is greater than 133. Next question is 141 and 110. The hundreds place is same, but in the tens place you have 4 and 1. 4 is greater than 1, so 141 is greater than 110. Let us move on to the next exercise, smallest and greatest number. Identify and circle the smallest number. So here we have been given with three digit numbers, 119, 190 and 129. You'll have to apply the same rule for this also. First look at the hundreds place, all three are 1. Next look at the tens place, 1, 9 and 2. We need to find the smallest number. We know 1 is the smallest when compared to 9 and 2. So 119 is the smallest number. Let us quickly do some exercises in this. 87, 97 and 127. So we have two digit numbers and 1 3 digit numbers. So you can ignore the 3 digit number now because it is definitely greater than these two. So compare 87 and 97. In the tens place you have 8 and in the tens place you have 9. And 87 is lesser than 97. We know that 8 is lesser than 9. The next question is 148, 142 and 144. Here we have the hundreds place and tens place to be same for all the three numbers. So look at the ones place, 8, 2 and 4. So which is the smallest number? 142. Last example in this series is 200, 100 and 199. The answer is 100. Let us move on to the next exercise, circle the greatest number. So comparing 124, 150 and 109, you have to look at the tens place because hundreds place is same. 2, 5 and 0. 5 is the greatest of these three. So 150 is the greatest number. Circle the greatest number in this. The answer is 177. The next question is 163, 168, 165. The greatest number among these three is 168. Next question is 180, 108 and 118. Hundreds place is same. So look at the tens place. You have 8, 0 and 1. We know that 8 is the greatest of all. And 180 is the greatest number in this series. That we have completed identifying smallest number, greatest number and comparing numbers using symbols in this video. Arranging numbers in increasing and decreasing order will be covered in a separate video. Links to all related videos are provided below in the description box. Dear viewers, if you like the content of my video, click the subscribe button and also the bell button and choose the all options for notifications of all videos that I make in my channel. Give a thumbs up and share this video and please do provide your feedback in the comment section and I look forward to that. Thank you for watching my video. Meet you again in the next video with more informative sessions.